Welcome back! This is Michelle Paré.
Hi!
You probably know her from her incredible YouTube channel, and of course back in the day she was a producer at BuzzFeed. We've seen like a lot of long form content start to appear on YouTube, and you were one of the first people that I feel like really went all in on that, like successfully. You make your life so much harder than you need to for the sake of your own content and for
people like me.
I wanted to ask you just a little bit more about what drove you to start doing videos like that and like making the transition into making your own content. How did that all start for you?
Well, so when I moved to LA and got the job at BuzzFeed, I also at the same time was signed to a professional cycling team. It's like road racing.
Wow.
Random, I guess. And there was a period of time, I want to say like 9 months, the first 9 months I was in LA, where every day I was working at BuzzFeed, and every morning I was waking up at like 4 or 5 to go train. And every Friday night, I would go to LAX and fly somewhere in the world and race all weekend and then come back. It was insane. I really, truly just wanted to be an athlete.
Wow.
But then I realized, like, once I, at BuzzFeed, I got offered a full-time position, that I had to make a decision of which one I wanted to do. Mm-hmm. And I realized that I could find a way to infuse this love of pushing myself mentally and physically into the videos that I do. My coworker Jordan and I made this list of what are the craziest things that we've never seen done on the internet and who would be dumb enough to do it, And it started with, we thought, well, no one's ever done UFC fighting on the internet before. Like, I know Jake and Logan are like,
at that point, nothing.
So we trained with a UFC fighter for 60 days, and at the end, did a fight at our office against each other. And that was a wild, crazy experience. And from there, I trained for a marathon in 10 weeks and then ran it. It started from a place of like asking myself, how many things can we just try and what will perform well on the internet? What I wasn't expecting was the feedback and reception of other people feeling empowered to do their own thing, which has been now my current driving force for everything I do. Every piece of content I make, I want it to be educating, entertaining, and inspirational so that anyone can watch it. And I always say with our videos, if we can inspire one person to do it, then we've done our job. Like, the views are whatever, like the views, sure, I'll take them, they pay the bills, but like,
you know, the videos.
Yes. But also, like, at the same time, some of my favorite videos are the ones that don't necessarily like go viral or perform
sure
the best.
Sure.
My favorites that didn't necessarily perform the best was a video where I trained with a professional clowning troupe for a month. Like, nobody even knows this video exists, but we did it. And I love that video because clowning is really hard. At the end of the video, I actually performed in front of an audience in Hollywood, like on a stage.
Wow.
Did like a clowning act. And I just have so much respect for every profession, community, or lifestyle that I try, because everything's hard. It makes you realize that, like, it makes you realize that everybody is doing their best to just get through.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah.
I think that one that's really special to me right now is my most recent one, in which I go to Firefighter Academy.
Unbelievable.
Thank you. It's nuts. And it was so special because I feel like I learned so much more about what firefighters do beyond literally fighting fire. Like, I didn't know that firefighters are the ones to rescue kids from active shooter scenarios. I didn't know that they are involved with paramedic work. And I just didn't realize the horror of going in a burning building. Like, we see it on TV all the time and we take it for granted what it really means to be wearing 60 pounds of gear, pulling a huge fire hose, and then dragging a victim out of a building, the pressure that takes. It's a lot of like, not just training, but like me spending time with people of the community on and off camera.
Is there something that you want to try but maybe right now like feel maybe a little bit intimidated by or scared to do?
There are a couple. So the first one is doing an Ironman. So an Ironman is like a multi-mile swim, then a 100-mile bike, and then after both of those, you run a marathon.
Oh, so it's like the most insane triathlon.
Yes, it's like the piece de resistance of triathlon. I also want to do, this is a crazy, crazy idea, but with the election happening, so we've been trying to make this video happen. I don't know if it's gonna happen, but I wanted to do the video, I became a politician, and literally like run for public office and see if an influencer with some sort of following can leverage the following to become a politician. I've always thought about like, well, how do you run for public? Like, where do you go?
How do you sign up?
You know? And then I was Googling, and it's expensive.
Really?
In order to run for some of the higher levels of office, like senator or whatever, it's like several thousand dollars just to apply to be considered. It makes me think about like, is it really a democracy if not literally anyone
exactly
can do it?
I mean, it's really, I think you would be exposing. I didn't even know about that, and I think a lot of people wouldn't know. So I think you'd be exposing an entirely new part of something that is literally going on right now.
It would be cool, but we're having trouble finding like an election that I qualify for, because you have to be like 30 something for a lot of them.
Okay.
And not only that I qualify for, but that will occur before the main election, right, so that we can have our video.
Are there any videos that you have done or had ideas for or started that maybe didn't make the cut or didn't turn out how you expected or for whatever reason didn't make it?
Yeah, so there was one video we did entirely filming start to end, 4 months.
Wow.
Our editor was several weeks into editing and we had to scrap it. It was a video where I trained like a Playboy model. I worked with a personal trainer nutritionist and I told them, train me as if I was about to do a new photo shoot in 6 weeks.
Wow.
And I did the photo shoot.
Oh my God.
They exist. And after all of that, we were in the middle of editing and I found out that if I were to post the video, a couple of the brands that I was working with would no longer want to work with me anymore. And it was this really, really hard choice of, do I make a statement as a woman of like claiming my body and saying it's okay to pose and embrace who I am? Or is it smarter for me to not do that, allow my own career to grow without any of these like weird hiccups or, you know, way back wins, and do it later or do it at a different time? And I felt a lot of like guilt for a while too, that did I sell out by choosing to not post the video? And I think I've had to come to the conclusion that like, no, I mean, I had the experience, it was for me. And it was important for me because sometimes I understand like you have to play the system in order to break the system. Mm-hmm. And so in order for me to do that, I understand I need to grow as far as I can and then use that leverage to make the way for other people. I don't know.
I mean, I think that's such an honest part of the decisions that everybody has to make. And I think what you're doing is so beautiful and so cool.
Thank you.
Sharing that, I think is really, it's really insightful. So
thank you so much for being here.
Thank you for having me.
This was, I never know what to expect doing one of these things, but Michelle Corray, please, please check out her content, her channel. It'll all be listed. Obviously, you won't regret it.
Thank you so much. This is so
incredible. Oh my God. Oh my God. I just broke Rebecca.